Hello everyone, with you Krivulya and Charly, and welcome to the second final episode of my making of this hairstyle. Please, if you want to support this channel, watch the video until the end, because there is important information about this. After that, we apply another Edit Guides modifier in which we can activate different groups and start painting them by selecting by group. To select the first group, enter its number, press the Enter key and then press the Select button. Next, activate the paintbrush and create a groom color channel, which is important for Unreal Engine. To dye your hair, first choose a color. Then select the groom color G channel and activate multi-channel display color. When we start painting, the color will be applied to all hair, not just to the selected hair. To start drawing on the selected hair, you need to activate the effect selected only option. Next, we can select a second group, activate a different color and paint it. Do the same for the other groups. You can use any color, including one color with different shades. That's how I got this color. By the way, you can uncheck the effect selected only option and paint the top any color you want. The result is an output that will work in Unreal via Vertex Color. A little later I will show you how to achieve this. So, let's take a look at what other modifiers I used to achieve the final result. These are ChangeWidth, Generate Strand Data for Unreal, and PushAwayFromSurface to make sure the tip of the tail doesn't intersect the body. That's all I want to tell you about the ponytail. Now let's talk about the knot. I created such a mesh and let the hair flow over it using the HairFromMeshStrips modifier. The settings here are quite simple. These are 20,000 hairs and 60 points per hair for better quality. If few points are entered, the ribbon of the node will be noticeable, reducing the realism of the model. Now, I will remove the top three modifiers that I use to control the intersection with other objects. Then, I will talk about the Frizz modifier. I added volume to this knot using the Frizz modifier with these settings. The following Ornatrix modifiers are simple in function and purpose to those shown in the previous objects. Now that we've covered all the objects in Maya, let's talk about customization in Unreal Engine. In Unreal Engine, I always use the shaders that Leonhard from Ephere and Roman Tsyganov team helped me to create. Material settings include many customizable options. I already have a tutorial on my channel that shows this shader. The model and shaders are available for purchase on CGTrader. Now let's talk about customizing the project. I used colors like this in root and tip dye color to get this hair color. For color selection to be available, you must enable the apply hair dye option. I didn't use albedo and vertex color in this example, but I'll show you how to use vertex later on, as promised. And these are the settings for all other parameters. Now, let's take a look at the baby hair settings. This part of the hair has slightly different settings and color to ensure proper blending with the main hair and a smooth transition from skin to hair. I also used separate settings in the material for the ponytail. So, that's it for materials. Now I'm going to talk about two more things, and then we are going to start working with Vertex Color. To avoid losing RootUV when re-importing Alembic to Unreal Engine 5, always make a copy instead of re-importing. For the presentation of my scenes, I use the lighting presets from Metahuman Lighting project, which is available on Unreal Marketplace. So, let's take a look at how to work with Vertex Color in Unreal Engine 5, which we will now create in Ornatrix Maya. I'm going to use the regular plane as an example to make it as clear and quick as possible. Immediately export this object in a VBX format to prepare it for import into Unreal Engine. The next step is to apply the Furball preset to this object and adjust the length of the hair in the GuideFromMesh settings. Adjust the direction of the hair using the surface comb modifier applied to edit guides. Set HairFromGuides to 100%. After that, we add clump by guide. Next, enable the Add Clump Index Channel option in the clump settings and use this channel in the Frizz modifier to get this effect. After that, add another Frizz modifier and make these settings. Let's also add a length modifier to make the hair vary in length. Now, add the Edit Guides modifier above the length modifier. Select the paintbrush and add the groom color channel. Before the Edit Guides modifier, add the Generate Strand Data modifier. Inside it, we will make the following settings. At the very top, add another modifier, Generate Strand Data. In this modifier, let's configure the parameters so that Unreal sees only one group. After that, select the full option for the curve in the ChangeWidth settings. This will make it easier to adjust the thickness of the hair in Unreal Engine. Now, we can start painting this object. Go to Edit Guides. Next, we choose a brush and paint with whatever colors we want. Now, let's start painting by groups. So, we will activate the root mode and go down to the Strand Groups tab. To select the first group, enable the Use Strand Groups option and enter a 1 in the Strand Group field, and after that, click the Select button. Select any color and check the Effect Selected Only option to paint only on this group. Start painting. Next, select a different color, activate the second group and paint in that color. Now, let's export the resulting output to Ornatrix Alembic. To export selected objects in Ornatrix Alembic format, choose File, Export Selection, Ornatrix Alembic and make the necessary settings. Import the previously exported plane into the Unreal Engine scene. After that, import Ornatrix Alembic, check for RootUV and be sure to make these settings. Now, don't waste time creating a groom object and just drag the imported one into the scene. Apply my shader to the groom object, enable Use Vertex and adjust Vertex Blend. You can blend the groom vertex color with original melanin, albedo or leave it fully colored. The vertex color in your scene shows the coloring you used in Ornatrix. If you liked this video, don't forget to write about it in the comments, put a like and subscribe to the channel, and please, watch this video until the end. Friends, if you need quality 3D hairstyle references, go to 3D.sk website. The site has two categories, groom 3D scans and groom photos. There aren't many scans on the site, but there are enough hair photos to start making something for your character already. Just a reminder that you can become a channel sponsor and get a voiceover in another language, a collection of my references and 100% discount on all my assets. Just click the join button to do it. If this is your first time on this channel, then here you can learn all the tricks and secrets of 3D grooming in Ornatrix. Also, get your questions answered and get inspired by reference from the games. Subscribe and write in the comments how long you do 3D and why you chose this field. What influenced this? If you like what I do, I will be very grateful for any donation to Donatella at the link in the description and channel header, buying my models on CDG Trader or Station, as well as the purchase of any of the plugins in an attached commentary. What's in it for you? It's very simple. If enough money is collected per month, I will be able to devote my full time to creating lessons for you. That is not 3 hours a day, which, as you have already noticed, not enough for the fast release of new episodes. Also, don't forget to check out the YouTube community, as I share there all kinds of news, uploading answers to questions, talking about the time spent time on lessons, and so on. And of course, don't forget about my Instagram, where I upload all my work and work in progress.